Hi everybody, and welcome to Lecture 6 of the Digital VLSI Design course at Bar-Ilan University. I'm Dr. Adam Teman, and today we'll start moving to the physical domain of the VLSI design process. So what's next? We've basically finished the front end of the design process, and we'll now start the back end of the design. So the front end was this part over here, where we basically defined all the logic and how we're going to build our chip and how it's going to fit together. And now we'll move to this part, which we often call the back end. The reason it would be called the back end is because it's more associated with making the metal layers, I guess, or the connections between the different cells, which is done at the back end of the line in the design process, versus beforehand we defined our logic, which is associated with the transistors, which are made at the front end of the line. Okay, so to start, we'll move between tools with a logical approach to ones with a physical approach. Then we'll make a physical foundation for our design. So the first thing we do is we'll draw up a floor plan. This will include making what we call big decisions or important pieces. We'll decide where they are, such as the IPs that we have, the different input-output circuits, the power grids, the special routes, and etc. After that, we can go and we can place our gates. When we say placement, we're talking about placing the whole like sea of standard cells, the whole set of these Lego pieces that we have in a big box, different AND gates and NAND gates and so forth. And when we do that, we have to take into consideration two things, congestion and timing. When we finish our placement, now we have put our flip-flop somewhere. So now we know where our clocked elements are. So then we can go on and build a clock tree, see how we distribute the clock to every part of the design. Finally, we can route our nets or do detailed route, where we actually go and connect all of the nets to all of the pins in the different gates and IPs. We have to take into account DRCs, our design rules, and of course timing, noise, and other things. Finally, before tape out, we'll clean up things, we'll verify, we'll make sure everything is connected and that we are breaking no rules. So illustratively, we can look at this as such. So our first step is we're going to move to a place and route tool or PNR tool, and that will contain an initial floor plan, like what size our chip is, how our pad ring is made. These things are the pad ring. And for example, where our core area where we have our standard cell rows are. Then we'll go on to power planning. We may build some rings of VDD and ground for a good distribution of the power around the chip and bring some stripes of power to bring power and ground a lot better into the standard cells themselves. Next, we'll go into our placement. Well, we'll actually place the standard cells in the floor plan, in the core area. Once we have our design placed, we have to see where our different flip-flops are, our clocked elements, and then we can go out and build clock trees, which these things would be the buffers that we added during clock tree synthesis. Okay, now that we have all of our elements basically in place, we can go on to what we call detailed route, where we actually go and connect nets to every single part. And finally, we can prepare the tape out, we can add the filler cells, we can do all kinds of other things, do checks and so forth, and be ready to go. And what we'll get in the end is something that looks similar to this picture over here. So, looking at that from a higher level, I guess, perspective, we can look at what we need for moving from the logical to the physical design. We have to define our design. That's usually a .v, a Verilog file. We have some sort of a Verilog netlist that came out of our synthesis. We also have our SDC constraints, basically the same SDC constraints. There may be several modifications, but they're basically the same SDC constraints as we had during synthesis, which tell our tools what our optimization goals are. We have to define our operating conditions and operating modes. That's MMMC, and we learned all about that. Okay, and we now are going into the physical world, so we have to have technologies and libraries, such as left files. Okay, finally we take our whole set of inputs and we define a floor plan, or the area that we want to put our stuff into and what it's going to basically look like. And now we can go into what's called the physical design flow. Once we finish the physical design flow, we'll get a detailed layout exported as a GDS2 file. So, during synthesis, our worldview was a bit idealistic. We didn't care about power supplies. We just knew that there was some sort of VDD and ground, or one and zero, but we didn't really care about where the power was and how it gets everywhere. And you can see here on the side, there's a more complex chip that there are different parts of the chip with different power domains and so forth. Maybe even the power is turned off in one of them. So this is much more complex than we did up till now. We didn't care about physical connections or entities. We didn't care about clock non-idealities. We always put that delta skew as zero and that delta jitter and so forth as zero, right? Therefore, in order to start physical implementation, what we have to do is we have to define our global nets, that say what VDD is, how it actually connects to each one of the cells and so forth. Each one of these parts we'll discuss later on. Okay, we have to provide technology rules and cell abstracts. So we have to tell it what the DRC rules are and what the left files that include like the size of our cells, where the actual pins are and so forth. We have to provide physical cells. These things were unnecessary when we were doing logic functionality, such as filler cells that just filled up the empty area of the floor plan, or tie cells that tie gates to one or zero constants and so forth. We have to define hold constraints in all operating modes and condition. This we saw we do with MMMC. But we could have used MMMC already during synthesis, but hold was very easy to meet. We had an ideal clock. We didn't really check it. We only checked setup. Now we have to do hold as well. And we have all kinds of things like low power definitions, such as voltage domains, power gates, body taps, etc. This is a bit outside the context of this course, but it is something that we have to do when we move to the physical domain.